गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू लेसन 5 मिनरल्स एंड एनर्जी रिसोर्सेज। योर कंक्लूडिंग पार्ट, व्हाट आर द हजार्ड्स ऑफ माइनिंग। ओके, फ्रॉम देयर विल स्टार्ट देयर। व्हाट आर द हजार्ड्स ऑफ माइनिंग? हजार्ड मीन्स इफेक्ट्स, इल इफेक्ट्स, नेगेटिव इफेक्ट्स ऑफ माइनिंग। The dust and noxious fumes inhaled by miners make them vulnerable to pulmonary disease, the diseases which are being affected in our lungs due to the inhaling of the dust particles, various minerals from the coal mines, bauxite mines, etc. Second is there, the risk of collapsing of mine roofs, inundation and fires in coal mines are constant threat to miners. What is that? The roof of the coal mines, they may fall down, and the miners, the workers, they get buried under these roofs. It is always a threat to the mining workers. Then mine fires. Inside the coal mines, there are chances of fires. And methane gas is released and causes fire, which also leads to the death of large number of workers. The water sources in this region gets contaminated due to mining. The dust particles which are been flying in the air, they get settled over the water sources, river, lakes, ponds, and contaminate the water. If people are consuming that water, then they are prone to various diseases. Dumping of waste and slurry leads to degradation of land, soil, and increases stream and river pollution. Waste material, when they are dumped, it is degrading the land, and slurry, mineral plus water equal to slurry, when they are being dumped in the area, it creates the water pollution in the stream, river pollution in the river there. Which industry is known as killer industry? The answer is there, mining industry. Why there is a need to conserve minerals? The total volume of workable mineral deposit is insignificant fraction, that is only 1% of the earth crust. We are rapidly consuming the mineral resources. Rate of consumption is faster, whereas it required millions of years for to be created there and concentrated. Number C or 3, the geological process of mineral formation are also so slow that the rates of replenishment are infinitely small in comparison present rate of consumption. In this sentence also means the same, only rate of consumption is faster, rate of formation is slower. Mineral resources are finite and non-renewable. Okay, you cannot renew it immediately. It will take millions of years there for its formation and concentration. Rich mineral deposits are short-lived. They will get exhausted some day or other day. Continued extraction of resources increasing the cost of mining. If you go more and more deeper for extraction of mineral, the cost of extraction will be higher. How can we conserve our minerals? We should use mineral resources in a planned and judicious and sustainable manner, so that we will use the minerals for present generation as well as keep in mind for future generation. Improved technologies need to be constantly evolved to allow the use of low grade ores at low cost, because most of the industries are using only high grade ores. If the technology will develop for the use of low quality ores, then the good quality ore will be conserved and the cost of mining will be also reduced. Recycling of metal by using scrap metals and other substitutes. Vehicles which are damaged due to accidents, they are considered as scrap metals. They should be recycled so that new fresh iron ore will be consumed less for the production of steel. Next is, they are distinguished between conventional and non-conventional sources of energy. Conventional sources of energy, they are the traditional sources of energy. They are used generation after generation. Example is coal, firewood, cow dung, cake, petroleum, natural gas, etc. Whereas non-conventional sources of energy, they are the non-traditional sources of energy resources. They are of recent use. Example, solar energy, wind energy, tidal energy, nuclear energy, etc. Name the most abundant fossil fuel of India. It is coal. Name some uses of coal. It is used in thermal power plants. It is used in steel plants. How is coal formed? It is formed due to the compression of plants and materials for millions of years. Classify the coal on the basis of their quality. The best quality coal, from top to bottom I am telling, the best quality coal, hard coal, is anthracite. Next to anthracite, we have got bituminous coal. It is popular commercial coal. Then we have got we have got lignite, the low quality brown coal, and the extreme poorest quality of coal is their peat. Classify the coal on the basis of their ages. One is Gondwana coal. It is 200 million years old coal. It is found in the states of Jharkhand, Odisha, West Bengal, in the districts of Jharia, Bokaro, Talcher and Raniganj. Jharia, Bokaro, Talcher in Jharkhand, Raniganj in West Bengal. Then, tertiary coal. It is 55 million years old coal. This coal is much younger than the Gondwana coal. It is found in the northeastern states of Meghalaya, Assam, Arunachal Pradesh and Nagaland. Okay. In this way, we have classified the coal on the basis of ages, Gondwana coal and tertiary coal. The Deccan Plateau region contains the Gondwana coal and the northeastern region of India contains the tertiary coal. Okay, please do these things in your copy. Thank you.